So if neutrons are neutral, protons are what charge?
Positive.
So which thing is negatively charged that is involved in making chemicals?
The electron.
Electron. Good. So you can change the answer if you want to. Okay. Which element has the highest electronegativity? That one, I thought I wrote a page down. Here's a book. There is a chart in the book. It's almost like a multiplication tables. It's something you just have to memorize. Okay? But here's what I remember. Here's what I would remember. Actually, really don't read the book. If you look on the periodic table of that blue paper, the cheat sheet, find fluorine.
Where is it over here?
Fluorine, which has the symbol F, and it's a noble gas, which means it's in group 18. To the far right.
Just F?
Yes.
Is that at number 17?
Oh, like, it is 17.
Is it group 17?
Yeah.
Oh, whoops, my bad. I was close.
Okay.
That is the element with the highest electronegativity. And without going into a lot of detail, it's just how much attraction there is when it bonds. So, if you have fluorine, which is in the upper right-hand corner, it is the most electronegative atom. Everything else works toward it. Okay, so if you are working your way to fluorine, the higher up you go has higher electronegativity, and the more to the right you go has higher electronegativity. So like the arrows would be going toward fluorine. And that's just something in your head to remember. But if you just remember fluorine has electronegativity, then you're good.
Oh.
Which is the answer to H, fluorine. Okay, which set of tools provide the most precise measurements for calculating the density of an irregularly shaped rock? Now, if you were in real chemistry class, we would get a rock and we'd get some stuff out and we'd figure out what the density is. Do you remember the formula for density?
No, but is it one of these papers?
No, it's not. It's not. Density is mass over volume. Because if you had a sponge or a brick, and you threw them in your pool, what would happen to them?
The sponge would float, and the brick would sink.
Cause why?
Cause it's heavier.
Okay, and heavier is amount of mass in that brick.
Mm-hmm.
So if the brick and the sponge were the same size, there's more mass in the brick because it would sink. It's more dense.
Mm-hmm.
So your brick, these were all little particles, have a lot more particles per volume. Because volume is what? Amount of what? These relatively have the same volume. So what, they have the same what? They take up the same amount of
space,
okay? So mass per unit volume, they both have the same volume. If the little dots are the particles or the mass particles, which one has more mass?
The brick.
Okay, so this has more mass per volume. That has less mass per volume. So this would sink.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so if density is mass over volume, it's asking what tools could we calculate that with? If we had a lab, we would have been shown all these tools, and I'm sure the tutorial about the tools was like in the first or second week of school.
Mm-hmm.
But which two things, one thing measures mass and one thing measures volume? What's your best guess?
Well, I don't really know what a flask is, so
okay.
I didn't pick either one of those.
Okay, a flask is like a weird shaped beaker. Like, whoa.
Oh.
Remember that, I don't know how many labs you did in school, but that's a flask. The beaker are the ones that look like a little cup.
Yeah.
Okay, so here's a beaker. Here's a flask. What else we got?
A graduated cylinder.
Okay, graduated cylinder are the tall ones. Ooh.
Can I have one of those tests? What yes. number are we on?
They're in the back.
They're in the back.
We're
okay.
on number
okay.
three.
Okay.
So here's your cylinder, your graduating cylinder.
Okay, what's a balance?
I was thinking like a scale.
Yeah, a scale that measures like your weight, which is equivalent to mass. Okay, so then we got a balance. I'll just write balance on there since you know. Balance, which is like a scale. Okay, so which one, if we had a weird shaped rock, there's our rock, which one would measure mass? Which tool for sure you know measures mass?
The scale.
Okay, the scale or the balance. So we're going to narrow it down to B and C. Okay, so we have a flask or a graduated cylinder.
I'm going to go with the cylinder.
Yes, because, like I said, if we were in an actual lab, the cylinder's measurements could go up from like 5 milliliters to, mine, the school went up to 200. Mm-hmm. A flask were always really large, okay? So you would fill up, let's say, the rock to 100 mils of water, mm-hmm. put the rock in, see how much it goes up, and that difference would tell you the volume. Mm-hmm. So if it started 100 milliliters, put the rock in, and went to 125, what's the volume of the rock?
25
milliliters, okay? So you would weigh it and divide it by 25 milliliters. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's number three. Number four, which is an example of a chemical change, straight definition. There's chemical changes and physical changes. What are the difference between the two?
The physical change is like ripping the paper, and then chemical is like when something happens. Chemically, I guess.
Okay, if ripping a paper is a physical change, why is it a physical change? Because it's still what?
I mean, it's still the same thing that it was, just...
Yes.
Doesn't change its stand?
Yeah, right. It changes, it keeps its identity. Mm-hmm. Paper's still paper, whether you rip it in half or wad it up. What can you do to paper to make it a chemical change?
Burn it.
Burn it, because it goes from being paper to what?
Ash,
smoke, heat, all that stuff. So, and you said burning paper, so did you get four right? Oh, okay, good. So what's number four?
F.
Methane is burned in air. Methane is a gas. Mm-hmm. It's flammable. It's like the little propane tanks, except it's a methane. It's still a flammable gas, and you're just burning it. If gold is melted, it's still gold. If you have copper and it's stretched, it's still copper. If you coat iron, it still is iron. So, good job. Number five. Okay. What volume will 50.2 grams of carbon dioxide occupy at STP? All right. So, you're going to use your cheat sheet. So, you're given what information in this question? Because one of the hardest things to do is going to figure out what equation to use. So in the question, what data are you given?
What?
In question number five, like, what information do you have in question number five?
You have, they give you the type of element.
In question number five, though. Like, if we're looking just at question number five, mm-hmm. What does it tell you? What are you trying to figure out? What does it tell you?
This says what volume.
Okay, so we're looking for volume, and what other information do they give you to help you figure out volume?
Amount of grams.
Okay, so what volume will 50.2 grams of carbon dioxide occupy as to be? So which, there is density over volume. Density equals mass over volume. I just found that. Yeah. All right, so which formula do you think we use? And it says at STP. What does STP stand for? Standard temperature pressure. So that means temperature and pressure are staying the same. And I'll give you a hint. Let me find it. So what volume? Okay. On your cheat sheet,
You're looking for volume, and you're given grams, but you may have to change your grams to moles.
Is it a molar volume?
Yes, okay. So molar volume. So your molar volume, I'll just put in the equals, what is it, liters? 22.4 liters per mole. They just write it a different way on the cheat sheet. Okay, so what do you think we do?
Divide it by one, or?
And we're given 50.2 grams.
Where'd you get the liters from, the 22 liters?
That is on the cheat sheet, yeah.
It says 22.4. Okay,
wait, you got it from right, yeah, the molar volume at STP.
Yeah, the molar volume in the second box.
Okay, 22.4, okay.
All right. So what do you think we do?
Well, if it's asking, I don't understand, because if it says it's asked, the answer is one of the liters, but mm-hmm. you have the liter up there. You know what I'm saying?
Oh,
well, I mean, you're right. Like, that is in the equation, but if you're looking for liters, then...
What is the volume equation? That's right. Okay, hold on a minute. I need a calculator. You go grab us a couple of calculators out there.
You made it? Okay. I'm gonna... we're having technical... we'll be back.